Hello guys, Skippy Shamino here with my part 6 for my leveling guide, The Road to 40, and you guys are almost done. So it's only Michigan and Alaska, and then you guys are level 40. So I'm now in Alberta. For the guys that didn't stay in Florida and want to go to Alberta, you guys can already see why I think you can come to Alberta in a leveling guide. You see it here, I got now the 17 kilogram net and I got 18,000 currency. Of course, that's with premium again, so that's 12k if you don't have premium. That's a very good money farm, because today was a bad day for the Northern Pike, because it was a cloudy day. Therefore, you see here Atlantic Salmon 2 at the start of the day, even in the best time of the day, I didn't have a lot of Northern Pike. You need to go here with float fishing too. Why? Because it's a lot better for the Northern Pike. It's the same in Michigan. Everybody is there going with the shiner, the 6-0 hook, getting the Northern Pike. It works a lot better on Northern Pike. It's a little bit in this game, it was always like that. Bobber fishing, you are going to get more fish than with lure fishing. Of course, you need to do an extra investment for the bait, but I think it's still better to float fish for some species than to go with the lure. So, it's a lot of money. And I'm going to show you guys how you need to get the Northern Pike. So today was a very bad day. It was a cloudy day. The best day for Northern Pike is sunny day. It was the same in the series for the Pike tournament. And I think I had 8 to 9 trophies in that tournament. And that was enough for the semi. So that's the best day. We started at 11 and we fished, I think, so 11 a.m. And then we fished 8 hours later. That's then 7 p.m. and that was a very good day, because we went with the lure. So if you guys go with the shiner, you will get a lot of fish. Okay, I invested in a new setup. This setup you can even use if you want in Michigan, but I'm not going to do it in my leveling guide, because this is going to be from level 26 to 34. Then you can get the 120 kilogram net and you can get the Brutus. Just to be sure, because I got the impression I did with the Phoenix setup, I did Michigan too, but sometimes it was on the edge to get the fish in. So I'm going to switch. So you need to invest in this setup, but I will show you guys a little bit later how much it costs. It's not a lot, and you get your money very quick back here. Even without premium, 5 days is easily 60,000-65,000 currency, and you're building up. So let's have a look what you need to do. So in Alberta, there is only one pech. So you need to go all the way here to the right. And you guys can check my video too, how you need to catch a Northern Pike. It's just the same. But I'm using there the casting spoon, but the casting spoon is not that good anymore. It's more a crankbait fish now. That is changed with the past. So you just need to throw over here. That's the position. So let's throw without the marker. You need to be above 40 meters and let the bobber just flow to the dam. It always going to the right, and then you need to wait. And that's how you need to catch the fish here. 80 centimeters deep for O-hook is more than enough. And that's what you need to do. So let's have a look that we can catch one. It can take some time, because the pike likes to nibble the whole time. Nibble, nibble, nibble. And then he goes like a torpedo away. So it goes really fast. You need to be very quick in striking. Otherwise, sometimes you are going to lose a fish. But I'm not even sure if you miss a fish with a strike that you can do something about it. I think it's just an RNG. Because I was watching my... I always record my competitions. And I was watching the Cheesy Cat. And... the fish that I missed, I didn't strike slower than the fish that I got. I was checking, was my line tension a little bit too far, or did I have too much line out, and it was just the same. So I think it's more an RNG thing than a skill thing. I think sometimes the game just decides the next strike you always going to miss. Because sometimes you even can wait 4 seconds and you get the fish in. So it just swims away, you just get... And you even get the fish in. So I'm not sure it's really skill based, the striking. And that's a pity, because you just need RNG then. And in competitions, take it from me, it triggers me a lot in my head. Because if you miss 3 to 4 fish and you see that the first guy got 5 to 6 kilogram more, he probably missed 3 to 4 fish too, but you don't know that. You always think, okay, I could be number one, and now I'm maybe sixth or seventh. So here is a northern pike, and you already see it gives a lot of currency. So that's the position if you want to go for Atlantic salmon. You can check my bobber guide too on the Atlantic salmon, it's just the same. So it's very strange at the moment because so many people are saying, yeah, the game changed for 70 to 80%, and I played the beta. I just did the same with the info that I got, and it was all the same. Okay, sometimes you got a random fish somewhere, and you know what's so strange is about some people is they now talk about fish that is moving. And you know when I won the bass tournament, on that moment fish was moving too. I had 9 hotspots, and when I didn't get the bass on a hotspot, I went to the other spot. So they didn't implement it in this beta that kind of fish behavior. It was already in the game for years. So that's so strange. But yeah, whatever. Sometimes I'm a little bit amazed. Most of the time, that has to do that people didn't fish outside hotspots, so they didn't know. And yeah. But I think it's funny that now all of a sudden the fish is moving, and yeah, it's just the same like it always was. Sometimes your hotspot is gone, and you need to go to the next hotspot. Sometimes you got now that you don't catch anything anymore, but you can do what you want. You are not catching anything. You can change your stuff, but it's not going to work. So it's yeah, I'm sometimes amazed about what people say about the game. But yeah, it's how it is. If one guy says the fish is migrating, another guy is going to say the same because he's not catching fish on that hotspot. But in the past, you had like 10, 12 hotspots for every fish in the most lakes. So it was just the same, I think, than it's at the moment. And this is, by the way, an Atlantic salmon guy. So what you need to do is you see that you can catch a lot of fish. So I'm just talking to you guys and I'm catching fish. So what you need to do is you just need to throw to this tree 40 meters, 80 centimeters again, and that's how you need to do it. Okay, so let's go to the global map because I'm going to show you guys what you need to buy because you are now level 26 and it's a lot of money. You guys already can see it. It's a very good farm. It's not far away from the bass, but on a very good day, if you got like 6, 7 trophies in, they are most of the time 4 to 7 kilograms. So that's you fill your net a little bit faster on a good day than compared to Florida. But yeah, it's bobber fishing. And if you don't like bobber fishing, just stay in Florida. So let's go to the shop. So what did I do? So first of all, we are going to the landing net. So it's level 26. So level 26, you buy the 17 kilogram one before you come to here. And you need to buy the match rod setup on level 26. It's just 26. I remembered because when I went to Louisiana, I took this with me on the beta. So you need to take the Phoenix 450. That's this one, that's 9K. Then the spinning reel, I think Fatboy Spin 5000. Or is it, yeah, Fatboy Spin 5000. And let's have a look what kind of line. I'm using 0.35 millimeter. I'm using the pear-shaped bobber, a 4-0 hook, shiners 80 centimeters. So that's what you need to do, guys. I cannot say more about Alberta. You can make nice money there. But it's of course float fishing. So buy the 17 kilogram net if you're level 26, get this set up and you're done. The next video is Michigan, and then it's Alaska, and then I'm done with the leveling guide. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope that you enjoyed. See you in the next video. Bye bye.